The man accused of hitting and killing a Johns Hopkins student in October pleaded guilty. Today, Thomas Megan faced sentencing in the death of 20-year-old Miriam Frankel. 11 News reporter Kim Dacey is live at Mitchell Courthouse. She has more for us. Kim?
Well, Rod, when the judge sentenced Megan today, he told him, "You have caused immense harm and you have to pay the price." That harm was very evident in the courtroom today as those who were affected by his crimes spoke out. Forty-year-old Thomas Megan was sentenced to 13 years in prison Wednesday for a hit-and-run accident that killed Hopkins student Miriam Frankel in 2009.
The Hopkins accident could have been prevented if they would have put him away right after he hit us.
Megan was also sentenced to 9 years suspended for another hit-and-run accident 3 months before the one that killed Miriam. These victims were injured but survived. They, along with Miriam's family, addressed Megan and the court before the sentencing.
I wanted to cry. I wanted to get up and, like, just fuss them out. I wanted to do so much, but I'm limited by what I could do and say.
I felt that he heard, but I felt like he didn't really want to look at the people that he hurt. He didn't even show any type of emotion.
These victims feel Megan got off too easy given his long history of traffic charges, including 9 previous DUI convictions before these 2 incidents.
I feel as though they should have locked him up the first time. Once they caught him after he hit us, they should have kept him there. He already had a numerous amount of DUIs on his record. It's no reason that he should have been let back out to do it again.
Now that he will finally be serving time, they hope the consequences of his actions will sink in.
And I hope he repents or feels bad about what he did or something. Just change it, like a change of heart.
Megan will be eligible for parole during his 13-year sentence, and he'll have 5 years of probation whenever he does get out of prison. Reporting live in downtown Baltimore, Kim Dacey, WBAL-TV 11 News.